der jüdischen Rasse in Europa.
In the mid-1930s, German dictator Adolf Hitler began his quest for world domination. With his invasion of Poland, he began a reign of tyranny that would last 6 years. Most of Europe collapsed under the strong arm of Hitler's armies, and its people became victims of Hitler's ruthlessness. Followers of Hitler committed atrocities, persecuting and slaughtering innocent people. Why? Because of their race, religious beliefs, and Hitler's hate. Incarcerated at concentration camps, they died by the millions, most of them Jews. December 7th, 1941, in a surprise attack, Japanese fighter pilots bombed the U.S. naval port Pearl Harbor. This ruthless act of aggression became the impetus that drove the United States of America into war. The states came together as a nation, as men and women from all walks of life united to help support the cause. Sacrifices were made here at home, but the ultimate sacrifice was made by the young men, many of them just boys, who enlisted and were drafted into the military to prepare for the fight ahead. On November 25th, 1940, the El Paso contingent of the Texas National Guard was federalized and activated for duty as a division of the U.S. Army. The unit, later known as a fierce fighting unit, was composed of mostly Hispanic youth. These school-age men dropped out of Bowie, Austin, and El Paso high schools to serve. Many didn't speak English, but understood the cause and enlisted in the National Guard. Company E of the 141st Infantry Regiment, 36th Division, became a well-trained group, tight-knit and hardy. Among these elite soldiers was a man by the name of John L. Chapin, born March 15, 1913, a son of an El Paso family, a product of El Paso and Isleta schools, and commander of Company E. Member of the 36th Infantry Division, 141st Infantry Regiment, hero, recipient of a Silver Star and a Purple Heart, John L. Chapin, a son, a father, and a husband.
Well, he was quite handsome. He was tall and well-built, and he was a funny person. He had a wonderful wit, sense of humor, and he was so principled and so loyal and steadfast, and it was just wonderful to be with him. And his personality, I think, has gone over into Paul's personality quite a lot. Kind and enjoy life and having fun and yet wanting to be a good father and husband. And he was a all around person, just simply a wonderful person. They had seen what was going on in Europe. You know, action started over there in 1939. And he had seen what was going on in Europe and knew that it was wrong. And philosophically, he was just willing to make the sacrifice, which was not easy, to leave your family and go over there and do that, and thinking that you might not live through it. It was a very big sacrifice. Company E was a group of men all from El Paso, mostly were Hispanic, and these men had been with him from the very start. He had trained them in his own way, and they were really a prize company in the Army. And they formed a company that was so loyal to his leadership that he didn't ever want to leave them. Five times he was offered a majority and turned them all down because he just didn't want to leave Company E. And he would have had to if he'd taken that promotion. In letters, after he died, I received a few letters from some of these men, and they said they would have followed him anywhere.
Company E's battle baptism happened at Salerno, Italy. On September 9, 1943, the 36th Infantry Division landed on the beaches of Italy. Under the cover of darkness, the 36th charged the beaches, attacking strong German defenses. The sands were blanketed with razor-sharp barbed wire, and the air was saturated with heavy artillery and machine gun fire. Company E was relentless, and their action reflected the character of their company commander. Tough, disciplined, and courageous. El Pasoan Sergeant Rafael Torres was one of the many soldiers who served under Captain Chapin. He spent those wee hours on September 9th cutting through barbed wire, exchanging gunfire with German machine guns, and disabling German tanks. A hero and highly decorated, he is one of the few still with us to reflect.
I call to an open area to where I could get in, where I could get, where I was going to throw a grenade from, but I couldn't throw it in the bomb position. So I started to get up, but at the same time I saw the turret of the gun moving in my direction. So I went flat again and pulled back. And then I noticed the slits. They have slits for the people in the tank look outside. If I can put a bullet there, that that will fit that tank. So I stood up and aimed. A couple of times I had to lower my rifle and wipe my eyes because perspiration was blurring my vision. Finally, I had the right aim. I slowly squeezed the trigger and bang, and the tank went in reverse at full speed, knocking down trees and everywhere. I was very surprised.
And so were the Germans. The U.S. won the battle and eventually the war. But success came at a cost. The Battle of Salerno was one of the bloodiest in history. Many perished, and the sight of a fallen soldier was sometimes difficult to accept. Sergeant Torres and many others would see the ultimate sacrifice, a fellow man's life for his country.
As I look at the young man, he looked like a teenager, what in the hell is he doing here in Italy? He should be going out for the football team in the school, or trying to find a date for the coming prom, and now he's dead. And something happened within me that I took it personally, I guess, that this young man, so young, would be killed.
The liberation of Europe and the defeat of Hitler came inch by inch. Bloody battles were fought throughout the Italian campaign, especially in Salerno, San Pietro, and on the Rapido River. Eventually, Company E went on to fight for 5 years, in 5 campaigns, in 5 countries. The cost of freedom was high. Over 50 million lives were lost across the world, and our nation mourned the loss of 300,000 individuals, including that of Captain John L. Chapin and members of Company E.
Captain John Chapin, professionally known as Captain John to his men, wounded on December 16, 1943, during the Battle of San Pietro. While recovering in the hospital of his wounds, potential wounds that could send him back to the United States, Captain John found out that his division had orders to cross the Rapido River. Captain John said, "No, I brought these boys overseas, and with the help of God, we'll take them back to Texas or die trying." Captain John left the hospital and joined his men. During the Battle of the Rapido River, which took place on January the 22nd, 1944, Captain John tried and tried to get his men across. They were broken into 2 waves. The first wave made it. Contact was broken. Captain John was found, his carbine in one hand and his telephone in the other. It was obvious to all who came over what had happened on the other end. They were out of ammunition. None of them survived. Captain John Chapin was awarded posthumously the Silver Star.
Throughout time, millions have fought and many have died to preserve our freedom, uphold our flag, and to protect our frontier. Headstones stand tall across the world, reminding us of the many wars and battles fought. Each gravesite represents a soldier, a warrior, an unsung hero. And there are those with the insignia KIA, killed in action. Action that should never be forgotten. Under the shadows of the Franklin Mountains in El Paso, Texas, far removed from his resting place in Italy, a soldier's patriotic pride is remembered. A school with his namesake was built to continue the character, values, and courage that he stood for. The gentleman known to his men as Daddy Longlegs from El Paso, Texas, will forever be immortalized in this state-of-the-art facility.
It's such an honor. I just can't imagine that after he'd been gone 56 years, this wonderful thing has happened to honor him. It's just unbelievable. And it's the most wonderful school. The building itself is just unbelievable. It's so beautiful and it's so state of the art. Everything about it is just right up to the minute. And the students that I met were just so enthusiastic and proud of their school, and I know they will make a really wonderful institution out of it. Having named a high school for him, I think that as the students there learn about him through the years, if they will let him be their role model, it couldn't be better. He had all of the characteristics of a really fine human being that they would do well to follow.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Please remain standing for the presentation of colors, the national anthem, and the Pledge of Allegiance.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets reckless, bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing as the color guard leaves the building.
Who's next? We gotta keep going. Don't let them disrupt you by screaming. So who are you introducing?
It's just a big
deal. Don't just talk over. You're doing
great. A very special thank you to our Chapin Army JROTC instructors, Command Sergeant Major Nathan Shaw, Sergeant First Class Edgar Olivas Menares, and the Color Guard. Also, thank you to our choir. Please remain standing for an ensemble by our senior band brass members.
Thank you.
Thank you. Please be seated. At this time, we would like to recognize our distinguished guests from the El Paso Independent School District. Please stand when you are introduced. Board of Trustees, Ms. Isabel Hernandez. Superintendent, Ms. Diana Saavedra. Chief of Schools Officer, Dr. Carla Gonzalez. Deputy Superintendent, Mr. Vince Sheffield. Chief of Operations Officer, Mr. Alan Wernicke. Assistant Superintendent of Elementary Schools, Dr. Blanca Garcia. Interim Assistant Superintendent of High Schools, Sean Mena. We are also thankful to have joining us today the principals of the Mighty Chapin Husky Feeder Pattern. Mr. Michael Mendoza of Bassett Middle School. Ms. Carmen Dwyer of Park Elementary School. Ms. Richie Handy of Bliss Elementary School. Ms. Nancy Hansen of Logan Elementary School. Mr. Armando Llanos of Travis Elementary School. Thank you for supporting Captain John L. Chapin High School. My name is Brianna Montoya, and on behalf of the class of 2022, I would like to welcome you to Captain John L. Chapin's graduation. Please stand as I welcome Paul Smith, Senior Class Vice President, to lead us in our invocation.
Good afternoon, faculty, staff, family, friends, and the class of 2022. Please bow your heads for our invocation. We will soon embark on a new journey. Surround the graduates with your grace. Bless us with hope so that we move into the future with eager and open hearts. Help us put the knowledge, skills, and insight gained through our education to use for the good of all humankind. Remind us that the only limits we have are those that we impose on ourselves. Inspire us to believe in the goodness of life, even when faced with challenges and difficulties. Strengthen us as we proceed to the next chapter of our lives with perseverance and determination. Help us to encourage one another to be generous and to learn today to lead tomorrow. We ask this in your name. Amen. Please be seated. At this time, we would like to lay a bouquet of yellow roses in a seat reserved at each Chapin graduation. This seat is in honor of Captain Chapin's wife, Velma Chapin Perkins. She visited Chapin when it first opened, and yellow roses were her favorite. Now it is my pleasure to introduce to you our graduation speakers, salutatorian Skylar Quiros and valedictorian my friend Zachary Magdaleno.
Thank you, Paul. Welcome, parents, teachers, administrators, and the class of 2022. Good afternoon. My name is Skylar Quiros, and I'm going to ask you a question you've probably already been asked thousands of times. And that is, what have you learned? Everything we've worked on circled around this one question. What have you learned? In the past 12 years, we have been taught a lot of information, whether you think so or not. We were taught how to read and write, how to do math. We were taught tons of history and science. We were taught interesting information and not so interesting information. But overall, we were taught information that will help us in our lives. So what have you learned? Our teachers, our administrators, our peers, our parents, our families, our neighbors, and all those close to us, have tried to teach us as much information as possible to prepare us the best they can for what they constantly refer as the real world. So what have you learned? In high school, I have learned a lot more than just academics. The most important lesson I learned was that none of us have to be the smartest person in the room. We don't have to have the highest grades or the best SAT score. We just have to try and be better than we were. Hard work and dedication are more important, qualities that will guide us in life and serve us well in difficult times. It is also important to remember that we don't always get to decide the things that happen to us in life, but we can decide how we react. Starting today, it's our turn to no longer be taught, but to take charge of our own learning. The question now isn't what have you learned, but what do you want to learn? What do you want to know, and what do you want to experience? The best lessons comes from the mistakes we make, the adventures we have, and the opportunities we get. Every one of us will have our own individual journey that will be unique to us. The lessons you learn from this point on will be completely up to you. So go learn everything you can and be resilient human beings. You will have the tools and opportunity to be your own kind of successful and add some good to this world. Be brave, be courageous, and be the kind people so many need. I wish you the best of luck, and I cannot wait to see the amazing things you accomplish. Thank you. At this time, I would like to introduce our class of 2022 senior class president, all Chapin boy, and valedictorian, Zachary Magdaleno.
Students, parents, faculty, and staff, I would like to welcome you all here today. The great mind of Albert Einstein once remarked, "Life is like riding a bicycle, and to keep your balance, you must keep on moving." As we all know, our class, our generation, was one of the first to have their academic experience disrupted by the COVID-19 pandemic. Our junior year was robbed from us, and most students were left with little to no social interaction. As soon as this year began, we were left struggling to adapt and attempting to resolve the commotion that is our senior year. However, it was our unrelenting determination that managed to make us that managed to guide us to our success. Captain John L. Chapin High School was founded on the ideals of collaboration and excellency. As an established leader in our school community, I have observed the efforts of my peers and educators attempting to piece Chapin together again after the pandemic. The tenacious attitude of the class allowed us to hit the ground running, rebuilding relationships with one another and making every senior event memorable. This strong determination to persevere in the face of any challenge and reclaim our senior year embodies the spirit of Captain John L. Chapin and establishes our role as the leaders of tomorrow. My fellow peers, never stop persevering. Never hesitate to further our success or put off those decisions that will affect our lives forever. We must always keep on moving forward, marching against the forceful currents of life. Diligence remains our key trait and will empower us wherever we go. Our future depends on it. Before I leave here today, I would like to express my gratitude for the many teachers that have allowed us to continue our success, even in the face of impending failure. Namely, class sponsors Mr. Guerrero and Mr. Renteria, and Mrs. Oshiro for fostering a welcoming and enjoyable environment during our senior year. And to the rest of the faculty, who have contributed their talents that have made Chapin what it is today. Balance is the key to everything. What we do, say, eat, think, and feel require an awareness of our balance. And through this awareness, we are able to continue to grow. We leave here today not as students, but as the forces that spark change in the world around us. We are the future, and it is our resolution that has made us who we are today. Now, please welcome Superintendent Ms. Diana Saavedra, who will certify the graduates.
Good afternoon, everyone. Before we begin to certify the graduates, I would like to share a few words with the graduates and with those of you who are with us this afternoon. Graduates, family, and friends, I would like to take a short moment to honor and remember the beautiful souls whose lives were cut short by the horrific act that occurred at Robb Elementary School in Uvalde, Texas. May we all find the strength, wisdom, and unity to do what is necessary so that no one has to experience a tragedy like this again. And I challenge the graduates here today to become part of the solution. Strive always to make our world a more peaceful and loving place. Let's have a short moment of silence to remember the 21 precious lives lost. Thank you. My name is Diana Saavedra, and I'm the proud superintendent of the oldest, the largest, and the best school district in the region. Yeah. I welcome you to Chapin High School, the Chapin High School graduation ceremony for the class of 2022. Thank you, Board of Trustees, faculty, staff, and our many alumni, and you members of the class of 2022. I'm honored to stand before you this afternoon as you conclude this chapter of your lives and the commencement of the next chapter. I, like all of you, am embarking on a new and exciting journey as our new superintendent. I've been so impressed with the caliber of students, staff, and teachers we have in this district, the drive and passion to build strong, well-rounded leaders of tomorrow makes me proud to be part of this dynamic team. As the first woman superintendent of El Paso ISD, the first Latina superintendent in El Paso ISD's history. Thank you. I am eager to usher in a new era of innovation and progress. I aim to listen, learn, and build on the good while addressing opportunities to evolve for the better. For all the girls walking across the stage this afternoon, I stand before you as evidence that you can realize your dreams. I see myself in all of you graduates, and it's my mission to create learning experiences so that every student in El Paso ISD realizes their full potential, just as you have today. To the parents, the abuelos, the abuelas, the tios, the tias, brothers, sisters, family, and friends who love and support you and stand by you and always cheer you on, this is your day as well. Graduates, let's give them a big round of applause. Class of 2022, you have transformed so much in 4 short years, from shy freshmen to extraordinary leaders prepared to take on the world. Among the extraordinary leaders today are 4 students earning prestigious military appointments, the most of any El Paso High School. Congratulations to those students. Their appointments demonstrate the strong tradition of military service here at Chapin, a legacy that would make Captain John L. Chapin and the men of Company E proud. Your commitment to excellence, the rigorous instruction and engineering focus you have received at Chapin has empowered you to go out there, be competitive, and pursue your dreams with integrity. Horace Mann, a famous 19th century educator, stated, "Education, beyond all devices of human origin, is the great equalizer of the condition of men." I firmly believe education is the opportunity equalizer. A high quality education prepares you to be the leaders of tomorrow. In life, you will have doors of opportunities that are open to you. Have the courage and curiosity to walk through those doors and achieve greatness. As I close, I would like to share with you 3 things my father taught me, which have been critical to my success. Those of you who have read articles about me or have heard me speak very fondly of my father. He came to the United States when he was 11 years old. He was an immigrant from Guadalajara, Mexico, and he started school when he was 11. He graduated from high school at 19 and went on to earn a bachelor's degree, a master's degree, and a doctorate degree from the University of Texas at Austin, which is testament to if you work hard, you can achieve greatness, and I know each one of you will. The things that he impressed on me and the things that he taught me were to operate with integrity. Never forget where you come from, and make sure you give 100% with everything that you do. Congratulations, graduates, class of 2022 from Chapin High School. I look forward to hearing about your accomplishments and how you will lead the generation to make the world a better place. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to ask Assistant Principal Candice Marufo to assist me in the certification of the graduates.
Thank you, Ms. Saavedra, for your inspiring words. At this time, I am proud to present to you the Chapin Class of 2022 for certification.
Thank you, Ms. Marufo. At this time, as the superintendent of the El Paso Independent School District, I certify that all students receiving diplomas today have met the requirements for graduation as prescribed by the Board of Trustees, the El Paso Independent School District, and the State of Texas, and are entitled to receive their diplomas. Ms. Isabel Hernandez, will you join me at the podium to accept the Class of 2022?
Ms. Saavedra, faculty and staff, parents, family, and friends, on behalf of the El Paso Independent School District And on behalf of the Board of Trustees, I accept the certification of the graduates of Chapin High School, the class of 2022.
Thank you, Ms. Hernandez.
Before we begin our roll call, I would like to share with our guests the significance of the White and Gold Performance Acknowledgement Court that was awarded to many of our graduates. These students have exceeded the Texas graduation requirements. In addition to the specific course requirements from TEA and EPISD, these students have successfully completed one or more of the following: completion of a dual credit course, advanced placement course, UT on-ramps course, bilingualism and biliteracy, PSAT, SAT, or ACT scores, and also by earning a state, nationally, or internationally recognized business or industry certification. In addition, this year, many of our students are wearing an emerald green cord. These were earned for community service hours. Recipients had a minimum of 120 hours to earn throughout their high school years. Our first graduates today represent the top 2% of the class of 2022. Once you have received your diploma and flowers for the CH, please take your seat on the stage for the remainder of the ceremony. Let's begin. Valedictorian, All Chapin Boy, Senior Class President, Zachary Nathan Magdaleno. Salutatorian, Skylar Austin Quiros. Next, our remaining top 2% seniors, Ingrid Camila Morales Gutierrez. Joshua Thomas Richardson. Jade Alexandra Morgan. Kyra Bell Rios. Frederick Chang. All Chapin girl, all athletic girl, and top 10%, Brianna Montoya. Our senior class of 2022 officers in alphabetical order: Samuel Thomas Balfour, also 10%. Isabel Andrea Isais. Jocelyn Lizette Rodriguez. Paul Daniel Smith. Top 10% and a senior class officer, Zachary Adam Vasquez. Now here's the addition of our top 10%. Ariana Isabel Almanza. Alfonso Ambriz Rivas. Valerie Lorraine Basurto. Will Neris Carion Colon. Josiah Choi. Ethan David Floor. Carl Delmont Freedy. Brianna Marie Gutierrez. Emily Marie Hutran. Brianna Marie Juarez. Brandon Lada. Jonathan Giovanni Lopez. Zion Jeremiah Baez Lopez. Manuel Armando Macias. Nalani Maldonado Guadalupe. Tristan Axel McKissick. Beyonce Yvette Medrano. Kayla Tali Morales. Epiphany Nain Wong. Adon Dennis Randolph. Katie Ruiz. Mason Ray Stanifer. Madison Elizabeth Thompson. Carlos Antonio Torrios. Valencia Estefania Vega Aguirre. Elizabeth Ashley Wagner.
Osvaldo Abraham Acosta. Ashley Marie Adams. Alfonso Aguirre. Jesus Alfredo Aguirre. Said Manuel Aguirre Valdez. Andre Ezekiel Alford Allen. Eric Daniel Abarado. Amanda Amparan. Brianna Alexandra Arambula. Gabriela Ariano. Nathaniel Seth Arenas. Israel Arredondo. Alfonso Andres Avila. Abraham Ricardo Ayala. Ava Pearl Bassett. Rebecca Marie Benavides. Valeria Betancourt de Santiago. Donovan Nathaniel Brookins. Avery Isaac Brown. Lizelle Christine Burciaga. Gianfranco Bustamante Soto. Destiny Nicole Butler. Damian Jesus Caban. Alexander Benjamin Kadungu. Angel Gabriel Camacho. Gabriel Jose Carnero. Jalissa Carreno. Vanessa Carreon. Naomi Marie Carrillo. Mion Carter. Axel Castillo. Francisco Fernando Carabos Jr. Wigan Andre Velasco Sea. Julius Sendejas. Sydney Eli Cereceres Castañeda. Emma Rayanne Chavarria. Misael Roberto Chavez. Viridiana Chavez. Jacob Ryan Chavira. Casey Kyle Clayton. Denzel Ramon Clinton II. Ali Jacob Cobos. Melanie Denise Cobos. Isaiah Colm Ochoa. Desiree Contreras. Kevin Daniel Cuellar. Tatiana Paris Curry. Haley Elizabeth Dadage. Donovan Elijah Davis. James Gavin Davis. Jayla Deonce Denson. Miliani Diaz. Sebastian Diaz. Dylan Tyler Dornow. Theodore Joseph Driscoll. Gavin Michael DePay. Martin Ochechuku Eddy. Tristan Hoel Endlich. Angel Miguel Enriquez. Noah Jose Enriquez. Janice Renee Enwefa. William DeAndre Epps II. Alexis Escareno. Dulce Maria Escobar. Fernando Alonso Escobedo. Gia Soleil Espinosa. Jackson Lee Evans. Georgia Faith Farrell. Zabria Ann Fay. Diego Fernandez. Dulce Maria Fernisa. Andrew Odlanyer Fierro Salazar. Andres Flores. Manuel Antonio Flores Jr. Jael Franco. Carissa Cynthia Galarza. Natalie Galavis. Guillermo Galindo. Luis Alan Galindo. Cristian Nathaniel Gallardo. Dylan Tiger Gandara. Adrian Garcia. Alpha Belen Garcia. Osiris Garcia. Celeste Anali Garcia Mendoza. Carla Rebecca Garnica. Ayana Chantel Goldthorpe. Christopher Frank Gomez. Jasmine Nicole Gomez. Sergio Eduardo Gomez. Abigail Gonzalez. Darren Gonzalez. Isaiah Isael Gonzalez. Mario Esteban Gonzalez. Bryson Ari Green. John Philip Green. Leilani Lula Griffin. Vanessa Mariah Guillen. Alan Guillen Hernandez. Aurora Marie Gutierrez Macias. Tristan Blake Harrison. Ismael Alexi Hernandez. Jasmine Hernandez. Jesus Hernandez. Matthew Joseph Hernandez. Rayanine Arlene Hernandez. Sabina Iritzel Hernandez. Ruben Armando Hernandez Jr. Faith Denise Hickman Mays. Fortune DeAndre Hickman Mays. Gabrielle Jalen Hill. Antoine Adams Holmes. Elizabeth Ann Haloub. Dontre Justice Hooker. Anthony Husky. Andre Darnell Ibavin McLeod. Brian Iniguez Flores. Andres Inostroza. Maurice Alexander Jenkins. Trenton Zane Jensen. Dominic Guadalupe Jimenez. Joshua Alexander Johnson. Donovan Fletcher Jones. Zafir Amon Amir Joplin. Drew Elizabeth Caden. Varun Frederick Kamath. Kyle Roberto Koch. Kaylin Avery Kraft. Daniela America LaBoy. Eli Lada. Creed Alexander Lawson. Damian Alexander Leal. Juan Carlos Leanos Jr. Malachi Sebastian Lee. Noel Michelle Lemon. Keelan Rose Lewis. Azaneth Sarai Lopez. Evelyn Grace Lopez Lozano. Nathan Lopez. Andre Lawrence Love.
Angelina Macias. Ashton James Majors. Naomi Nicole Magudegi. Jesus Marquez Jr. Brianna Sophia Marshall. Matthew Joseph Martin. Amory Bernice Martinez. Benjamin Isaac Martinez. Cielo Montserrat Martinez. Madeline Andrea Martinez. Vanessa Martinez. Macy Jordan McFadden. Megan Danielle McFadden. Caleb Luis Philip McGee. Nicholas Donovan McCain. Ruth Giselle Medina. Victoria Ariana Medina. Cole Matthew Mendenhall. Isaac Xavier Mendez. Jose Armando Mendoza Medrano. Felix Mesa Ortega. Tyla Yasmin Miller. Damian Morgan Mills. Abel Molina. Michael Wayne Molinar. Isaac Ruben Monroy. Carla Galilea Monroy. Giovanni Ian Montañez Rivera. Woo. Zoe Miana Moore. Elizabeth Carolina Morales. Isaac Ike Moreno. Samuel Joshua Moreno Jr. Cassidy Ariana Mullen. Alejandro Burnberry Manguia. Giselle Myers. Frida Julieta Navarro. Katia Crisel Navarro. Viviana Daniela Negrete Medrano. Henry Ning. Sincere Sagay Nicolò. Thomas Matthew Nuzo. Emily Christine O'Hara. Angelina Gimasoa Ogando. Kendrick Ogale. Diego Victor Orozco. Arthur Ortega. Bianca Vanessa Nunez. Noah Elijah Ortega. Ashley Joan Panatex. Sarah Michelle Partida. Timothy Ezekiel Pastran. Angel Saul Peña. Annabelle Grace Perez. Jorge Angel Perez. Luis Fabian Perez. Maxine Monique Perez. Amador Pichardo Rodriguez. Angel Aaron Piedra. Sylvia Pizzola. Noah Reagan Polin. Matthew Apollo Polk. Stacy Janae Porras. Sandra Liliana Quesada Salcedo. Alasia Larry Raiden. Javier Ramirez. Samuel Ramirez. Zadie Monique Ramirez. Sergio Ulises Ramirez Cervantes. Jonathan Ramirez Sanchez. Giovanni Ramirez II. Mercedes Magdalena Haani Ramos. Mirna Anaí Ramos. Brianna Alexis Reed. Adam James Reyes. Joseph Angel Reyes. Samuel Reynosa Ruiz. Abram Victor Rivera. Andrew Rivera. Matthew Jesus Rivera. Caden Fisher Robinette. Annette Yvonne Robinson. Christy Isabel Rodarte. Gabriel Rodarte. Gabrielle Mary Rodriguez. Caitlin Rodriguez. Marty Joe Rodriguez. Oyuki Adeline Rodriguez. Alan Armando Rodriguez Ontiveros. Abigail Rojo. Heaven Giovanna Rosales. Irvin Rosales. Marissa Nicole Rosario. Luis Armando Rosas Jr. Avery Catalina Rausch. Angelina Maribel Ruiz. Fernando Alexis Ruiz. Maya Saboteur. Francisco Abanille Sainz Hinojos. Alondra Camila Salas. Christopher Brian Salas. Jason Daniel Salas. Sianiti Jesse May Salaswat. Aaliyah Ann Solis. Miguel Angel Salazar III. Michael Salcido. Daniel Salome Juarez. Diego Manuel Samaniego. Isel Vanessa Sandoval. Maya Ileana Saya. Gianna Lynn Shepherd. Jaya Nadal Sneed. Isaac Isaiah Soto. Matthew Victor Soto. Juan Amado Soto Jr. Nalani Soto Santiago. Jacob James Staggs. Malachi Samuel Stoltz. Damian Michael Stubbs II. Brock Anthony Tarchinski. Ethan Kale Taylor. Malcolm Isaiah Taylor. Mia Rayanne Thompson. Madison Patricia Tillett. Carlos Torres III. Marie Celeste Torres. Gabriela Renee Tovar. Eric Elias Tovar. Ethan Roy Thomas Turner. Leah Marie Urbina. James Edward Valadez Jr. Eliza Valencia. Ruben Alberto Valenzuela II. Amy Valero. Dennis Ilab Valles. Itzel Lizeth Valles. Christian Vargas Velez. Giselle Vega. Jacqueline Valerde. Emma Rebecca Vidal. Grace Galilea Vieira Estrada. Elijah Michael Villa. Gretel Andrea Villa Gomez. Samuel Javier Villasano Avalos. Vanna Danae Walker. Mason Andrew Wittenberg. Joshua Isaiah Wicks. Gavin James Williams. Jacob Dale Williamson. Jada Leanne Woolley. Amaya Anshulea Wright. Emma Riley Jimenez. Isaiah Christopher Zubia. Cassandra Alyssa Zubia.
Hello, everyone. Hello, my name is Jonathan Lopez, and I would like to congratulate all of you for entering this milestone of your lives. This is definitely something all of us will be remembering. I want all of us to look throughout all of the past 12 years and think about all the things you have done to become as successful as you are today. As we reminisce about our younger selves, and the memories that we have made with our teachers and our friends, I would like to take a quick moment to think about where we go next as we all diverge to meet our own goals. Everyone here has a special purpose that they will fulfill within their society. We, as graduates of Chapin High School, will strive to make the community a better place. I would like to share a quote from Dale Carnegie that has shown me to keep working hard and staying optimistic of my future. Remember, happiness does not depend upon who you are or what you have. It depends solely upon what you think. So start each day by thinking of all the things that you have to be thankful for. Your future will depend very largely on the thoughts of what you make today. So make sure that you have thoughts of hope and confidence and love and success. So I leave you all with this. Please look at the people around you, give them a smile, and think about how you will eventually build up the community that brings us all together. With our ideas, our beliefs, and our persistence, we can make sure that our dreams come true and make the world a better place. Congratulations to the class of 2022, and good luck to all of your future accomplishments. I would quickly like to mention that as soon as we turn the tassels, everyone, parents, friends, graduates, and family, we will all be meeting in the back or the north patio. So as soon as we finish the tassels and we all leave, we will all be meeting in the north patio. So right now, with the class of 2022, please rise. I want you all to raise your right hand, grab your tassel, and on the count of three, we're all gonna be moving it to the other side. Are you all ready? Okay, one, two, three. Congratulations, class of 2022.